consultant general paediatrician at Barley Hospital, and I am also the chair for TPDs in North East and Central London, and I'm also a lead in child protection. So my career to date starts off with me wanting to be a paediatrician since I was a child. And I was one of those really sort of passionate, committed people. So I went to medical school, loved everything except surgery, got the gold medal in surgery, which really pissed off my male colleagues who were going to be surgeons. And then I came out the other end, really, really keen on paediatrics. And when I was training, there wasn't a college of paediatrics, and there was just adults. So you had to do an adult exam. And you got admitted into the Royal College of Physicians. And I did a bit of adult training, because that was quite a good idea before then doing my paediatric training. And then I went to paediatrics, and I selected all the jobs that I wanted to do. So I had a very flexible training, but I also had a training which meant that every 6 months or every year I had to apply for a new job, which is quite stressful. And I was also training at the time that although I'm not an academic by any stretch of the imagination, you had to really do some research in order to get the best consultant jobs and ideally get an MD or a PhD. So I went off to Chicago for 2 years and did some really, really awful lab-based rat work in Chicago, which I completely hated. Came back with a baby born in America. And then I applied for my consultant job after a couple of years as an SR. When I applied for my consultant job, which was very nice because I'd been a registrar there, so it was a bit of a nice leverage into that job, I was asked if I was going to complete my MD thesis, and I said, if you give me this job, no. If you don't, well then maybe I'll have to, because I'll get another, have to get another interview. So I never completed my MD, and it's never held me back. So I had a 6 week maternity leave in America, because that's all you get in America. So I worked all day, I had my eldest son, and then I went back after 6 weeks to full-time research. I then had two more children as a consultant, and I had 6 months off for each of those, but I've never had a sabbatical, I've never had any breaks at all. The great thing about my job is that I never know what is going to be happening day to day. So yes, I know the basic structure. I know that I have clinic weeks when I'll do two or three clinics in that week. And then I know I have about one week of doing attending, which is quite a lot of attending because we've got a 30-bedded ward, so it's quite full on when you're attending. My on-call commitment is one in eight now, which is the best it's ever been. Although curiously, I think I have never been busier in the whole of my career. So I started off on one in four, covering two hospitals, and I'm now on a one in eight, covering one hospital, but I'm much busier when I'm on call. And the numbers of trainees that I work with has escalated hugely, thank goodness, but that's because the workload is massive. And I think that my trainees work harder than I ever worked, even though I work longer hours. I think the intensity of the work is much greater. All the education stuff is obviously very much hands-on during the day, so it's either teaching or supervising or doing assessments or whatever, or doing TPD type stuff. Governance, I would say, is pretty minuscule, to be completely honest. And I've reached a point in my career where I've had to make a decision about how many audit, risk, departmental governance type meetings I attend compared to everything else that I do. And I have to say that those big meetings are taking a fairly low priority in my life at the moment, because I actually think that my best use of my time is training, seeing children, child protection, being very, very hands-on and supervising trainees. Well, my children, I have three, call me Le Shadow. And the reason they call me that, I think it's partly because I'm half French, and partly because when my youngest son was doing a French bit of homework, he wrote, had to write a little bit about every member of the family, and so he wrote something lovely about everybody in the family. When it came to me, he said in French, "My mum goes to work very early and comes home very late, full stop." And I said, "But you haven't said how lovely I am and how much you love me and how I support you." And he said, and he just laughed. He said, "No, I haven't, have I?" He said, "That's probably because you are le shadow." So I thought, oh God, that is terrible. And so what I do is when I'm at home, I'm always home on Thursdays when I'm not attending, and I'm as present as I possibly can be. And I do an amazing amount of baking so that my presence is felt even when I'm not with them. I'm a performer, so I always like a bit of drama. We've done quite a lot of hospital shows. I like singing, I've sung in a choir for years, I like dancing, I like music. But most of all it's friends and cooking. I do a lot of that. I think number one, I'm never ever bored, so I never get to the end of the day thinking to myself, oh, you know, I'm willing the day to end. Never. I love trainees. I get such a kick. I could not work in private practice without trainees with me, because I learn from trainees and I love the relationship that we form together, and I like the long-term relationship with trainees. And I love my patients. I find them fascinating, and the more complicated, in some ways, the better, because you know, the simple ones you can just sort out quickly. It's the really complex ones. And I think one of the things that I think is key for trainees to recognise is that you don't know it all when you become a consultant, and you may not have, I mean, all of us, all my colleagues, have continued to train in areas that we never thought we would. And perhaps for me, the biggest thing that I've learned a lot about is mental health, through doing some family therapy training, through working with physio who's brilliant at chronic fatigue, through working with mental health consultants. And I think that's what's really kept my interest going. And that's the hardest part. The non-organic, the medically unexplained symptoms, that's the hardest part. The worst part, undoubtedly, is unnecessary paperwork, unnecessary training inverted commas. So the fact that I have to do level 3 child protection training when I'm actually delivering it, but I'm not signed off unless I've done it. But all my colleagues in intensive care have to do basic life support training when they are delivering intensive care all the time. That kind of unnecessary paperwork, plus systems which don't work, admin that doesn't work because there's not enough of it, or it's not the people doing it aren't well enough trained. It's those frustrations, and also changes from the Department of Health that come upon us and tell us we've got to work in yet another new way when we've got a system which more or less works. That's a really good question. The advice I would give to somebody starting out is that I think it's still a fabulous career. I think paediatrics gives you a huge breadth of choice. I think many people don't know exactly what they want to do. They just enjoy working with children, they enjoy teamwork. And so you don't have to pin yourself down early on, but just enjoy every job that you do. Don't do a job because you think you should do it. Do a job because you really want to do it, if you can, if you're lucky enough to do that. Get yourself a really good mentor. And it doesn't have to be a formal mentor, just somebody whose opinion you value, and ask them to stick with you and advise you and support you along the way. Stick with it even when you're feeling down. And if you're feeling down, again, go and talk to somebody about it. Socialise a lot with your friends, go out for drinks, do stuff within the workplace that makes it fun. Don't just come in every day, do your work and go home again. The more you put into it, the more you get out of it. And above all, I think you should have fun. That you know, there, along the way, there are lots of opportunities to do other things in paediatrics. So I've done quite a lot of writing and broadcasting, made films, educational films, BBC type stuff. So all of those, I always say to people, just if you get the opportunity to do something like that and you're interested, always just say yes. Right, in 5 years' time, well, I by then will have come off the Encore Road, if that's my plan, hopefully, and be doing stuff more focused towards what I really want to do. In terms of, and so I would love not to do the nights and the weekends anymore. Pediatrics, I think, you know, we're talking a lot about how we can improve training to make it more flexible, and I'm really hoping that trainees are still going to enjoy doing pediatrics, are going to find it more flexible, are going to find they're more supported, and hopefully are going to find, for some of them, their training shortened considerably and more focused to their needs. What resources do I use? I think, you know, there are quite a lot of resources now that are becoming more available. So online, things like MindEd, Pediatrics Online, things like that, which are very available. I mean, I Google everything. So if I'm about to see somebody in a clinic with a syndrome I've never heard of, before I see them, I'll just Google it and find out a bit about it. I think my biggest resources are actually my colleagues. And I focus all my CPD on things that I'm really going to enjoy doing and gaps in my knowledge. I went on an allergy day the other day, which I found really helpful because I discovered I wasn't really up to date with that. Yes, I think CPD should be fun and should be something that's relevant to you.